Okay, so I work at a news corporation. I'm a DevOps engineer over there. It's been like around 14 months for me working over there. And being a part of DevOps team, my daily job looks like working with the developer teams and so on to help them set up their own infrastructure and then maintaining the site reliability of those systems by setting up the monitoring, alerting, and bunch of other stuff which helps them like keeping the systems uptime for most of the time. That's the kind of my daily job looks like. Otherwise, I love exploring open source. Even though if I don't contribute to something, I just randomly like to just see that what things are happening and just try to learn it. Right? I love automate the unautomated thing. That's one of my very fond kind of hobby that I really practice a lot. Yeah, so that's me.
Got it. So, what was your journey to becoming a DevOps engineer?
Okay, so my journey to becoming a DevOps engineer is definitely a roller coaster ride for sure, right? So, so I graduated in 2016 May, right? And then I had the option to join Indix, and when I came here, then I was given the option that whether you want to join to some developer team or whether you want to explore something very much new for you. Being right fresh out of college, I just knew that okay, being a developer, it means that you have to write some Java code or create some classes and something new, then definitely there is something much to it. Right? So yeah, then I thought, okay, let's give it a shot. And that's how I entered DevOps.
Yeah.
Right? And at Indix, at that point of time, we were having a two-member DevOps team. Right? And then most of the things at that point of time were Indix were very unstructured. Right? So being in DevOps at that point of time with a very fresh hand experience that most of the things were had to be set up in place and you had to like build things from scratch and then to make it work to the extent that people start respecting DevOps was it up to the level that appreciation it deserves, right? Because at that point of time, Indix was at stage because people didn't knew that that these problems even existed,
right?
So DevOps was that kind of work for us. That was a challenge that was actually thrown up to us as a part of DevOps team. And being right fresh out of college, it was like very interesting for me,
right?
Just be a part of this community and to just be a part of this problem space typically. So yeah, I mean that's how I entered DevOps, and so far it has been journey has been awesome. I mean my learning rate has been exponential.
Like, right.
I have learned typically all those major fancy tech, and not just like the fancy tech. To be very honest, I have learned that how to be a part of a problem and go from right from the bird's eye view to the most distilled level it is being possible. Just by breaking down the problem step by step, and then finally figuring it out that okay, hey, this is the root cause of something that has been there for a while, and okay, I am the one who actually will solve it.
Yeah. And then there's also the mental satisfaction.
Yeah, so it's like, so I'll tell you, right? So it's like being the Batman of the organization. Like you work in, right, you work in science, and your success actually makes the noise. Like,
right.
So it's that feeling.
Yeah. So can you tell us a little bit about your talk at this conference today about Plutus?
Okay. Okay, so in one sentence, Plutus is a kind of cost alerting tool that we have built at Indix that actually helps us to keep a track of the unknown events that happen upon AWS. So why did we build this? So we were working on a lot of things around cost cutting that we were having on AWS bills that we were paying. We were working on a lot of strategies. So Ashman built a lot of tools that helped us save a lot of cost on AWS. But certain things that we were quite missing on that, let's say there happens to be some of the events in our infrastructure, right, which goes out untracked, right, which people don't come across to know about it, right? So how do we like actually keep those things in track and like and just prevent those costs to be like being incurred upon our AWS bill, right? So that was a motivation that we definitely have to figure out something so that that these costs do like these untracked events do not cause the vain cost that we have, right?
Yeah.
So that was the kind of tool that then we came across. Then Plutus is the serverless architecture tool that helps you monitor all these costs. And yeah, that's what it does. And it's helping us to keep our costs like most stabilized over like past 1 year.
Sure.
And average around, so we incur around $100,000 bill on an average on AWS, because that's kind of a thing for us.
Right.
And with Plutus being in place, I don't remember being in last 1 year, we have crossed $150,000.
Very interesting. Can you now tell us a little bit about why people should even consider speaking at conferences and community events? Like what motivates you to spend so much time and effort to prepare presentations, prepare for the talk, and then finally coming down here on Saturday to actually deliver this talk?
From my perspective, so I'm probably amongst the youngest people out here in the crowd, right? So from a pressure perspective, if I have to say something to people who are just starting their career as me, right? So attending conferences like these and attending meetups like this definitely helps you broaden your horizon. That's what I believe. Because at your current organization, you are working on a set of problems, set of the challenges that your organization in its business point of view faces, right? And you are solving them, which might be right or might not be right problems that you have to solve to see yourself somewhat excelling in the career that you actually want to become, right? But you once actually be a part of the community in which the kind of tech area in which you would like to be a part of, right? Then you start exploring the challenges or the problems which other people are also solving.
Right.
This helps you identify that, okay, there is something more to it than what I'm currently doing at. And then you become a part of their problems and they learn from you. Right.
Yeah.
So it's a kind of a two-way process, right? And it ultimately benefits you a lot in the sense that, some of the problems you become to be very interested, right? Then that can kind of give you a kickstart to explore something very new within your own organization also, that hey, this is the kind of challenge problem that we were facing since a quite long time.
Yeah.
But these are the guys like who are solving it. Let's make a shot and let's give it a shot and try to solve something. Now if you take that you take away from a conference and solve something in your own organization, right? So that is something very useful, not only from the company side, but also from an individual side also.
Yeah.
That, you learn something and you actually help your organization grow. That's no other feeling can be greater than for an engineer.
Absolutely. Yeah. Completely agree with that. Thanks a lot, Aayush, for spending time with us. Yeah. We hope you have a great evening.
Good job. Thank you.